Hej, witam serdecznie w kolejnym odcinku zagrajmy w Assassin's Creed 3 i tak, zaczęliśmy od budowy naszej posiadłości, znaczy posiadłości Achillesa, tam ludzi zbieramy i tak dalej, ale też Achilles nakłonił jakiegoś tam typka, starego kapitana, by odbudował swój statek. No i tutaj statek jest już odbudowany, wcześniej to tutaj sobie leżał na pół zatopiony. A teraz jest już odbudowany i mamy misję związaną z nim. No to okej, zobaczmy co nas czeka. Nauka na błędach. Okej. Aha, mam przez mapę zacząć misję. Okej. Aquila musi popłynąć do Marta Vineyard, aby zainstalowane armaty na jej pokładzie. Należy także zatrudnić oficjerów, którzy będą dowodzić nową artylerią. Czemu ja zawsze mówię tak oficjerów zamiast oficerów? Nie wiem, jakąś taką dziwną nawyk mam. Źle wymawiania tego. To będę musiała tego pilnować. Oficerów, a nie oficjerów. Zawsze jak jest oficerów, to ja mówię oficjerów. Nieważne. Będę musiała tego pilnować. Anyway, zaczynamy tę misję morską w takim razie. Kolejna nowość. Ach, te przesądy.
Weatherly and sleek. She'll fetch 12 knots in a stiff gale. Near a ship from here to Singapore can outrun her on her best day. What do you say we take her out? Show you what she can do firsthand.
Where would we go?
As it happens, she still needs guns and the officers to command them. We'll launch straight away. Don't worry, lad. I'll make sure you sprout good sea legs. Haul in the mainsail! Get up the rigging! Hand over fist! Come on, men! Let's get her out where she needs to be!
Okej. No to płyniemy. Tak, Connor akurat powinien mieć we krwi pływanie, ale to mniejsza o to akurat. Już mamy 73 rok. Okej. Przyjmij ster. No okej.
Okay. You're connected to her now. Listen and feel. She's idle. If you call for half sail, the men will hop to it and she'll pick
half sail.
Okej.
The killer flies again. Do you feel it, lad?
No.
Set a course for Martha's Vineyard. We'll find our guns and officers there. She's a nimble vessel, but the faster she goes, the more cumbersome she grows, and the firmer your hand needs to be. Enjoy this stretch of open water before we come upon those shallows. Call for full sail if you like. We need more speed.
No, już płyniemy szybciej. Okej. No, wiem, spokojnie, dam radę. Żeby nas nie zniosło za bardzo zaraz. Spokojnie. Tak, jednakże, no, tutaj fajnie jest to pływanie statkiem ogólnie. Jeśli się pewnie to grało pierwszy raz, nie grając w następnej części, jednakże, jak się już Black Flag grało, no to trochę mech. No ale, jest w miarę okej. Okay. Całkiem fajnie zresztą to się pływa.
And if you want to make a quick tack, call for half sail. She's more maneuverable then.
Okay.
Full sail! Bend them all! Full sail!
Możemy przyspieszyć, mamy jeszcze kawałek do tego statku przed nami. Bo się tutaj jest sporo tych skał i trzeba uważać.
Mind those other vessels. Hold your tack to keep your right of way.
Mhm.
I want everything. Unfurl everything. Full sail.
Ciekawe jestem, ile będzie tutaj właśnie pływania statkami w tej części. Pewnie niewiele raczej, ale... Zawsze fajne urozmaicenie też. Ogólnie. Mam tutaj tylko 2 stopnie żagli. No Black Flag chyba były 3 z tego co pamiętam. Connorowi bardzo dobrze idzie. Przybił do wybrzeża. No dobra.
Ravishing as I remember.
After all these years, you sail all the way to the vineyard to pay me compliments.
We are looking for David and Richard Clutterbuck.
Nice to see you too.
Robert Faulkner, where the hell you been?
Sorry for leaving like I did, lads, but where I was going, no one could know. You two working much?
No. Between contracts at the moment.
Well, we're looking for gunnery officers. What would you two say to working with me again?
We'd be for getting into a few more scraps.
Good show. The Aquila is a fine vessel. We're fitting all the guns as we speak.
Looks like your friend's about to catch a beating.
Where is Charles Lee?
I don't much care for your tone, boy.
Hey, you don't want to be doing that, Biddle.
Bobby Faulkner turned to wet nursing. It's good you finally realize you're a shite sailor.
Whoa, 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 not in here, gentlemen. Better still, not at all. Bobby, take your friends and get out!
Let's go, boys. Our guns ought to be ready. Come on.
Connor jest trochę zbyt porywczy jednak. O, przemister ponownie. Dobra. Lecimy.
Templar. Who was he with?
Templar? The young buck was Nicholas Biddle. Nobody. Sails before the mast. Midshipman for the crown.
Are the guns ready?
Aye, but we won't jump in over our heads.
We'll find a suitable target and show you how they work. We've fitted her with a modest amount of guns to start, but rest assured there's ample room to add more should you feel the need.
No okej. Okay. Ja widzę, że parę statków się porozbijało lekko.
Looks like a British frigate with half seas over. Should do nicely for a spotter target practice. Bring her around broadside and when all guns are on target, call fire.
Aha, i tu jakiegoś sterowania specjalnego nie ma, tylko kierunek. No dobra. Bum. Okej.
You are a fast learner,
provided something interests me.
Ah. Getting a taste for the open sea, are we? We'll make a jack tar out of you yet. Now we should be getting back. The old man is like to have my hide for keeping you out so long.
No dobra, no to ruszamy. Starczy zabawy chwilowo. Ale kawał drogi mam do przepłynięcia, no ale też to szybko idzie w miarę. Oho. Opa. Opa. Jeju, dobra, trafili nas. Opa. Ajajaj. Dobra, chwila, obracamy się. Okej. Okay. To wyszło.
English frigate! I'll be betwattled another one. Where in the bloody hell did she come from?
Aha. Tak po prostu nas atakują. Spoko. Dobra, troszkę oberwaliśmy. Teraz na nich kolej. Zwolnijmy. Ja się spóźniłam. Dobra, nie trafili. Miło z ich strony. Nasza kolej. Druga strona. Jejku, jednak strasznie się dziwnie steruje tym statkiem. Nieważne. Zapominam ciągle się o chowaniu i straty statek. Dobry początek! Zatopię statek zanim w ogóle go się udało jako tako zrobić, jak naprawdę. Okej. Okay. No Okej. Tym razem mi się udało. Dobra. Kompletnie nie udało mi się zrobić tym razem tych pobocznych. No, całkiem fajnie było, przyznaję. Dobra, troszkę odpornie właśnie tak mi się steruje, no ale to raczej do przewinięcia wszystko. Nauka na błędach, okej. Do dupy im poszło, wiem o tym. Taka sytuacja.
What I need, and I'll give them to you. Simple. You got a ship. Could find them all to boot.
Who is that man?
Him? Some old salt always on about letters he's got from Captain Kidd. Nonsense, really, but he doesn't hurt no one, so I'll leave him be. Talk to him if you fancy, but be warned he'll chew your ear off. Anyway, your keeler's here for you. If you should get a pang for the open sea, we'll be waiting. Now, I implore you to head up the hill before the old man comes out of retirement just for me.
Okay. Dalszymy na górę.
And not even a goodbye before you left.
Sorry.
Well, what are you waiting for? Put them on. Once upon a time, we had a ceremony on such occasions. But I don't think either of us are really the type for that. You've your tools and training, your targets and goals. And now you have your title. Welcome to the Brotherhood, Connor.
Okej, tak po prostu. I zakończyliśmy sekwencję piątą. Czyli jak mówiłem, tą najdłuższą sekwencję teoretycznie. Przynajmniej patrząc po jej misji. No dobra. I wychodzimy z Animusa.
Happy to hear there's actually good news for once.
Yeah?
I've managed to locate a power source, and it's relatively close by. Up for a trip to Manhattan?
Is it safe to leave? Abstergo's gotta be looking for us.
Obviously it's not safe. Can't exactly sit around here hoping to get lucky, though, can we? We need that power source. Besides, I'm sure you can cook up some way to hide our movements.
Maybe. The Templars have access to all kinds of satellites and camera systems. We'll need to find a way to mask our digital signature. I can probably camouflage the van, too. But there's not much I can do for us.
That's an easy one.
Aha, okay. Założymy kaptur i nikt nas nie wykryje.
That they're completely prepared for the upcoming solar maximum. Disruptions to service are expected to be minimal.
If only they knew.
What's this?
A remote operated camera. It'll provide us with a feed while you're on mission. This will let us talk to each other.
We're almost there, so listen up. The artifact is in an office penthouse in Lower Manhattan. At this time of night, direct infiltration is going to get you noticed. I think we're better off having you drop in from above.
What do you mean, above?
Okay. Desmond, pamiętaj, by założyć kaptur.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
Yep, read you just fine. Now why don't you power up the camera? I've got pictures. Running diagnostics. Perfect. I've got a nice, strong signal. Just a heads up, there's no elevator access from here on out. You'll have to get up there the old-fashioned way.
Aha, że chwila, rozumiem, że w ten sposób właśnie tłumaczą ta trzecia osoba widok dla nas. Okej, okay, może być i tak. Bo tej kamery nigdzie nie widać tutaj, więc podejrzewam, że ona po prostu, my jesteśmy tam z tą kamerą, co sobie lata tym dronem. No ale okej, okay, lecimy na górę. Tutaj, mam nadzieję, że dobrze idę. Nie wiem tak naprawdę, ale chyba innej drogi nie mam. Brawo Desmond. Nie wiem co ty robisz ze swoim życiem, ale niech ci będzie. Desmond. Proszę. Dobra, czyli takiego lightowego rana teraz mamy. Ale... no dobra, fajnie, że w sumie wątek teraźniejszości się niewiele różni od wątku historycznego. Po prostu skakanie po wszystkim, co się da. Jak ja tu mam przejść? Chyba gdzie indziej mam iść. Chwila. Weszłam tędy. Tak, tak. Tędy weszłam, to gdzie mam iść dalej? Tutaj. Nope. Czuję się zawiedziona. Chwila, wrócę. Nie wrócę tutaj. Tutaj też nie wejdę. Wait, trzeba coś z tą bramą zrobić, jakoś otworzyć. Chyba? Nie? Okej. Okay. Dobra, tak po prostu gra nie bardzo mi powiedziała, co mam zrobić tutaj. No ale wystarczyło podbiec po prostu sprintując i wtedy ślizg był. No dobra. Dobrze idę? Ale widok fajny, rzeczywiście, miły. I teraz jeszcze lepszy. Tutaj Desmond. Nie, no to jednak to strasznie dziwnie czasem w asesynach jest, jak właśnie tylko jedna ścieżka jest na górę gdzieś. Sean zawsze pozytywne podejście ma bardzo. Na górę nie spadnijmy przy okazji. Once you reach the top of the lit up crane, you should be high enough to make the jump. Should? It'll be fine, don't worry. Well, you might want to worry a little. I'm pretty sure she was high when she was running the numbers. Sean! A joke. It was a joke. Or was it? To jest tak fajnie denerwujący zawsze. Dobra. Hopsa, tutaj oczywiście począł korzystać z drabiny. No w sumie chyba tam była krata na dole. No i tutaj też jest, więc... w sumie nie skorzystanie z drabiny w tym momencie ma sens. Wyjątkowo.
Jump when you're ready, but wait for my signal to open the too late and you'll miss the building.
No to co? Jolo! Okej. Rozumiem, że na tym lądowisku do tego dla śmigłowca mamy wylądować. Okej. Jakoś specjalnie ekscytująco to nie było. Można i tak. Za dużo gadał.
So who the hell is Daniel Cross?
Believe it or not, he used to be an assassin. The assassin, the way I've heard it told, but it turned out he was a sleeper agent for Abstergo, programmed to infiltrate and destroy the organization.
How did he know you were there? We could be compromised.
They must have caught me snooping inside their network and sent Cross to see what we were after. If they were aware of our current location, we'd know. Though, I will say this. It doesn't bode very well for future expeditions.
I've set up some cameras topside. If anyone shows up, we'll see it.
I'd suggest you go see about finding a socket for that power source. Or we can return to Connor if you prefer. All the artifacts in the world won't mean a thing without the key.
Okay. No to przydałoby się chyba za gniazdko znaleźć. Zwłaszcza, że chwilę czasu jeszcze mamy, albo najpierw pogadajmy z ludźmi.
I know everyone thinks I'm being silly, but I can't shake the feeling we're being watched.
We are being watched. By Juno. Or some version of her.
Do you think it's a recording? Or is she a ghost? Or something else? Is she talking to us the way Minerva talked to Ezio?
No clue. I mean, who knows what else they were working on down here? There's still so many rooms we don't have access to.
But do you think she's, like, literally down here, waiting somewhere, still alive?
Still alive? That's mental. And I mean, she'd be at least 75, 80,000 years old. So powerful, yeah, but not that powerful.
They came down here looking for a way to survive. Maybe they found one. Is it weird seeing Cross?
What do you mean?
It's different for you. You don't know about what happened, I guess. For a long time, he was important to us. He was a different person.
Sean said he was a sleeper agent, like Lucy.
It was different. She made a choice, but Cross, if you read the files, Abstergo just... They did terrible things to him.
Rebecca?
You're lucky. We all are. We have people who care about us, who look out for us. He was all alone, and the people he thought he could trust, they used him.
Did you know him?
No, but I knew Hannah.
Who's that?
She tried to help him. She trusted him. But there was a raid about a year ago. She stayed behind so the others could escape. Tried to reason with him, to see if she could fix things.
Well, what happened?
What do you think happened? He killed her. That's what he does. That's all he knows how to do. Sometimes it seems like that's all any of us know how to do.
Rebecca,
I just want to be alone right now.
Mhm. Dobra. Zostawimy ją na razie. Niech się pozbiera. A, gdzie jest Sean? Nie wiem, jego humor jest mi teraz potrzebny.
Ah, Desmond, there you are. Can I ask a favor?
Maybe.
When this is all over, I'd like to try turning the dial back on the Animus. Like, all the way back. To the time of the first civilization.
You think it would work?
There was no real loss of fidelity when you visited Altair. Then again, that was about 1,000 years ago, and I'm looking at going back at least 70,000 more.
Sure, I'd be up for it. It'd be interesting to see what things were like back then.
Excellent. I think it would prove most enlightening.
No, to może być interesujące rzeczywiście.
So this is how it started.
What are you up to?
Just brushing up on my American history. I say history. They certainly teach you strange things in the States.
Like what?
Well, for all the talk of this being a revolutionary war, it was a civil one. Well, not that kind of civil. I mean, there was no America versus Britain. It was Brit-on-Brit action. And you can clearly see how the whole thing got started. One war gave birth to the other.
You mean the Seven Years' War?
Exactly. Seems the Crown overspent in its attempt to keep the French out. Wound up with a great deal of debt. Believing that the colonists should help to shoulder the burden, new taxes were created. It was a reasonable request, even if Parliament was rather, well, undiplomatic about it.
Well, it's not really fair to tax people for a war they didn't want any part of.
What? Didn't want any part of? Did you not notice George Washington with Edward Braddock? He was right there in the middle of it. So here you have the Crown spending who knows how much money to secure a place for the colonists to thrive, and then, when they ask for a little bit of help... Right, look, think of it this way. King George and the colonists, they all go out to dinner, right? And when the bill comes, George asks for them to kick in and pay their share. Fair enough. But keep in mind, he's been taking them out to dinner gratis for decades now. But the colonists, oh no, they insist they only had a glass of water and a side salad. Never mind the table's full of half-eaten food and empty bottles of wine. Then when the king points this out, what do the colonists do? Oh, they flip the table over and they storm out the restaurant. Probably intending to turn later and burn it down.
You left out the part where the king pointed a gun at the colonists and asked them to cover dinner for everyone in the restaurant.
Right, right. Yeah, interesting take. If he pulled out a gun, and I'm not sure he did, it would only have been after the 100th failed attempt at getting them to pay their fair share.
But how do you define someone's fair share?
Well, with a war, apparently.
Interesująco.
I wonder how many other places like this exist.
There are dozens of them, all over the world.
And somehow no one's ever found one before us.
I don't think that's true.
Oh?
When I was at Abstergo, Vidic talked about silencing discoveries made by non-Templars. And I'm sure Abstergo has dug up plenty.
The things they must know.
Regretting throwing in with us?
No. Just looking forward to when we can finally trounce those bastards so I can dive into their archives. Oh? I think I found a lead on another power source. Later, Desmond. I'm in the middle of something very important right now. Just, that's a rule. Just follow that as a rule.
Dobra, 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 wiemy. Przydałby się znaleźć włącznik, ale jeszcze tutaj był nas ojczulek, znaczy ojczulek z Monda gdzieś. Kręcił się, biedak. Gdzie on teraz jest? A, tam. Hello.
Son. I owe you an apology. I shouldn't have lashed out like that. You have to understand, I've never been very good at this. Never mind that we live rather extraordinary lives.
Yeah, I kind of liked my ordinary one.
You can't escape who you are, Desmond.
So I've noticed.
Look, it's silly for us to go back and forth like this. I admit, I did a shitty job raising you. I apologize, I'm sorry. But it's important you understand it didn't come from a bad place. You're my son. I love you. I guess I was so busy trying to make sure nothing bad happened, I didn't consider the consequences. Truth.
I can't believe it's taken me so long to ask, but... How's Mom? She's not...
No, 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 no. Your mother is fine. we decided it was safer if we split up for this job.
I'm always assuming the worst.
For good reason.
Can I at least say hi to her?
I'm sorry, it's too risky. Maybe when we're done.
Right. When we're done.
Okay. Jeszcze coś?
Have we ever tried to make peace with the Templars?
Throughout our history, there have been moments. Several, in fact. But it's impossible. There are existential differences, insurmountable. If there were to be unity, it wouldn't be a truce so much as a submission.
But knowing what's about to happen, wouldn't it make sense to try and talk to Vidic? Come to an arrangement, even if it's only temporary?
We'd all be so busy watching our backs, nothing would get accomplished. Imagine that. We're more productive at war.
Well, have we ever tried sending in someone? Doing to them what they did to us with Lucy? Or Cross?
We have, and it's never worked. We've sent people who were either too weak and found themselves turned, or too strong and were unable to carry out the charade.
I just feel like we all want the same thing.
We use the same words, but that's all they are, words. In the end, it all comes down to freedom. We seek it, they detest it. And so there's never an end to the fight. Not until one side is completely gone.
Is that even possible?
Probably not. Our two groups have existed in one form or another since, well, since forever. But things can be better than they are. And that's something.
Did you look for me, Dad? When I was gone?
Every day.
Come on.
I mean it. Every night I'd look, searching for your name or variations of it, hoping you'd slip up. Abstergo only found you first because they had better access. A few more days and it would have been me.
Well, I'm here now.
And I'm glad.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Do you think Lucy regretted what she was doing?
I used to think I knew her well, but clearly that wasn't the case. So I really can't give you an honest answer.
She seemed so sincere, though. Like she really wanted to make a difference.
Yes, well, when I first met him, I thought the same thing about Cross.
It just keeps happening over and over again.
What does?
Everything.
Don't get weird on me, Desmond.
No, it's fine. I'm fine. Don't worry.
All right, then. You should think about getting back in the Animus. We've got to find that key. We should probably get back to Connor.
Okay. Ale ja tu widzę włącznik, tak więc od razu uruchomimy to. Papara, papa, znowu duchy. Chyba.
In the beginning, when we thought we could be saved, we sought to face the sun's wrath and contain it. Four towers would be built to pull her fury into this place and dispel it. But even with all we knew, with all we had, it would take too long. A thousand years we could labor, and still the work would not be done. The first tower was never completed. The project abandoned. We moved on. But while we labored on other endeavors, a few returned. They thought to automate the process. Metal might finish what flesh could not.
Aha. Dobra. Dowiedzieliśmy się troszkę o ich kolejnym pomyśle, a tu nie jest ten przycisk. Znaczy to miejsce na łącznik. No to pójdziemy do góry sobie. Tak, i ogólnie taki dziwny przeskok fabularny, ponieważ nagle po prostu w tej części dowiadujemy się, że jednak Lucy była tą złą i nie zostało to w żaden sposób wyjaśnione tak naprawdę. Że jednak Lucy była po stronie Templariuszy, tak to wynika ze słów właśnie tutaj całej naszej ekipy. A no właśnie nie powiedzieli tego wcześniej w żaden sposób. Nie zostało to wyjaśnione po tym, jak ją zabiliśmy w Brotherhoodzie. If we could not meet the sun's cruel embrace, perhaps we might rebuke it. Already we could generate the fields to protect us in times of strife. But these were small and simple things. To replicate them on a scale the size of a world. We lack the energy to make it so. Half the world, they said then. It is better than none at all. We tried. Again, we failed. A quarter, they asked. Even this we could not do. A sixth, an eighth, a tenth, they cried. The answer was still the same. Perhaps in time a city might be spared. But it was time we did not have. So we moved on. No to zajebiście wasza ochrona świata. No, naprawdę. Czy tu jest w końcu to, co potrzebuję? Tak. Okej. Kolejne tutaj części się uruchomiły. O, tam mogę przejść sobie. Tam już ona czeka. Rozumiem, że tam kolejny tam. Ten generator będzie trzeba włożyć. Or might it be changed? Here we learned the answer, and thought that it might save us. They were used to command, to control, to own. But we soon discovered another use. When enough sat enthralled and were told to believe, their thoughts took on form. What was imagined became real. If 100 minds could wish away a wall or create a tree, what might 1,000 do? 10,000? More? Might we change the consensus and will the threat away? We resolved to send one into the sky where it might illuminate us all. Once placed, a sentence would be uttered. Make us safe. In this way, we would change the consensus. We would save the world. But it never came to be. We sent a dozen of them skyward, but there was no way to maintain control, to direct the beam, to enthrall the world, to speak the words. Though this was strange and dangerous, what we tried next was worse. Ona w ogóle wygląda jak Voldemort, tak przy okazji. Nie, tak mi się kojarzy, wyglądam. Dobra, pójdę od razu do tego tam rządzonka. Kolejnej wypowiedź przesłuchamy już. Teraz, bo czemu nie? Porozwalało się wszystko. Travel back to change the past,
but we could not find a way. But forward, we could look forward. And so here we sought to see beyond ourselves and know what was to come. First, we watched to learn if our work would succeed. But the answer was always the same. So we moved on to other things. But she remained. The one you call Minerva. In time, she too stopped looking. And instead, began to speak. She called out across time, in the hopes that you might be saved. She hid messages where none might find them, save for you and those within this place.
Fascinating.
Tired of it. The cryptic warnings, the threats. Just tell us what you want!
But they are. We saw the Nephilim there. We seemed like grasshoppers in our own eyes, and we looked the same to them. Imagine trying to explain all this to a two-year-old, to a grasshopper. When they said the will of the gods was unknowable, they meant it. Literally.
I killed her, you know. I killed Lucy.
It was the apple, son. It was Juno.
I saw what she was. What would happen if I let her live? I could have stopped myself. I mean, there was a force there. But I didn't have to. I chose to.
Desmond.
Lucy was going to betray us and take the apple back to Abstergo. I saw the satellite launched. I saw them turn it on, and then it failed. Whatever's on the other side of that door, it benefits Juno. We need to be careful.
Okay. Czyli Junona ogólnie jest raczej tą złą. Ale i tak jej słuchamy. No dobra, spoko. Tak, czy tędy wejdę? Tutaj sobie, czy muszę naokoło? Chyba muszę naokoło. Ta. Wyraźnie muszę naokoło. Chyba źle poszłam. O, tam wyżej jeszcze jakoś wejdę? Niby tak, chyba tędy muszę. Tędy Desmond. Jeju. Nope. Ojej, to jak ja tam ma wejść? Dammit. Chwila. Jest jakieś przejście. Czy mi się wydaje? Nie, wydaje mi się. No, tędy nie przejdę. Dobra, wracamy się po prostu. Nie chcę mi się tutaj kombinować z tym na razie, skoro i tak... tutaj chwilowo to znaczenia nie ma. Czy tu wejdę, czy nie, bo i tak nie mam kolejnego urządzonka do włączenia tego. Uii. No okej, I ogólnie myślę, że w tym miejscu też zakończę ten odcinek. Mam nadzieję, że się podobało. I zapraszam Was do kolejnych filmów z Assassin's Creed 3. Bye bye!